Hello friends, welcome back to Home Theater Enthusiast. As I told you in the last video, I'll be showing you how to connect an AVR with a power amplifier in this video. So let's get to it. Before that, if you are interested in home theater builds, audio video component reviews like speakers, streaming devices, projectors, etc., subscribe to my channel and like the video if you actually like it. Here I am using the AVR and power amp from the brand Marantz, the SR6014 and MM7055. If you haven't watched the unboxing videos of these products, please have a look in my channel playlist. I will be providing the links in the descriptions below. So here we have the AVR and the power amp. This is the MM7055 and this one is the AVR SR6014. For those who doesn't know about the separates, I will give a brief introduction on this. Hope you are aware of AVRs, and the AVRs actually does two major jobs in your home theater system. One is the processing of the input AV signal, and the second major job is to do the amplification for the audio channels. There are other roles also, like video upscaling, full HD to 4K, 4K to 8K, etc. So basically all these types of processing is done by your AVR. So now comes the concept of separates. Here the things are little different. We separate the processing and amplification into two devices. The first one is known as the preprocessor or just processor, and the power amplifier. There are lots of such combinations available in the market today. People even use different brands also for each of these. Okay, so what is the advantage of using this? The major advantage is that each of the devices are made for doing their specific task, like processor is only focused on the input signal processing and the power amplifier is doing only the amplification for the audio channels. That makes them more efficient and hence consume less power and low heat. Another advantage is on the flexibility side, we now have the flexibility to give different power to each of your audio channels. That may be depending on your home theater room, the placement of the speakers, etc. Even you can have multiple power amplifier in your home theater setup with different power ratings, like 250 watts for your front channels, 100 watts for your surrounds, even 80 watts for your height channels, etc. There may be more advantages, I am not going in detail to that. So if you guys know more advantages of these separates, please comment below. So coming back, here I am using the SR6014 as the processor and MM7055 as the power amplifier. This specific amp supports two types of input connections, balanced and unbalanced. The RCA connections that we usually see are the unbalanced connections. And these are the balanced XLR connections. XLR connections have its own advantages like noise reduction in longer length cables. These cables keeps an inverted signal too with the actual signal. And at the receiver end, it will again invert the signal and add to the actual signal so that the noise will be cancelled. Okay, so I'm using the RCA cables today. These are Amazon Basics coaxial RCA cables. They are super flexible and budget friendly. I will give the purchase link below in the description. So now look at how we connect the audio output from the processor to the amplifier. Since I am using an AVR, I have to use these pre-outs to connect with the power amp. Please note, some power amplifier labels the channel name also. You can go with the same order or whatever order you need. Here I am not considering the labels. So let's start the connection. Take one RCA cable and connect it to the channel 1 on the amplifier. You can do it either way. Here I am first connecting at the amplifier end, then connect to the processor pre-out. Here I am connecting to front right channel. Similarly, connect the second cable between the channel 2 and the front left on the processor. Then center to channel number 3. Next, the right surround to channel number 4 and the left to channel number 5. So we are done with the interconnection between the amp and the processor. You can also use a trigger cable to connect between the AVR and the amp so that the amp turns on automatically when the processor is switched on. I prefer to switch on manually, so I am not doing that. Now we can connect the amp output to the specific speakers. So this one is for the front right, this is the front left, then the center channel, and the right surround and the left surround. So this is how the amp looks like once we done with all the connections. Hope you enjoyed the video. For any queries or suggestions, please comment below. And for more such videos, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you and see you in the next video.